Hey guys, welcome. In this video I'm going to use array modifier and will let you know how and where to use array modifier for different situation. Here is the model in which I have heavily used array modifier. Array modifier is generally used to create number of copies of single mesh so that you may not create a duplicate copy of the mesh at a certain distance. For such kind of tasks I will be using this mesh. To use it, you can find it in modifier tab, click add modifier and select array modifier. There are three types of array. Fixed count generates the numbers of copies as specified in count. Fit length generates enough copies to fit within the fixed length, which is given by length. And the fit curve generates enough copies to fit within the length of the curve object specified in curve. For this tutorial, I'm going to use fixed count. The relative offset will increase or decrease the distance of copies on X, Y, and Z axis. You can use negative value to have array on negative x, negative y and negative z axis. Put one value on the axis you want to array your mesh. Now press Shift A and select curve and then add circle and scale it up. You can use any spline from the curve tab. Then select the mesh and add curve modifier to your mesh. To make the mesh follow the curve, click the eyedropper and select the curve path. If it doesn't follow the path, then select the mesh and rotate the mesh 90 degrees on Z axis. You will see it will follow the curve. Other than that, you can also use the deformation axis to follow the curve without rotating it. Now if you increase the number of the array, you will fill the curve with the mesh and make sure that the array stays at the top of the curve modifier. But to connect the end with beginning of the mesh, you will just need to scale the mesh, or if you don't want to change the scaling of the mesh, then scale down the curve path. But with this method you will face deformation in your mesh. You can also solve this by increasing the polygon of the mesh or decrease the vertices of the curve path to match your mesh curve. But there is also another way to do it. Just hide the curve modifier and add an empty to your scene. Then press Shift S and select the cursor to selection. Then select the mesh and click the object tab and set origin to the cursor. After that, in the array modifier, check the object offset and select the color picker and select the empty to assign it as an object offset. Make sure that all the digits of the relative offset is set to 0. Then in edit mode, grab and slide the mesh on x-axis. After that, just rotate the empty on Z axis. And then again in edit mode, slide it on X axis. Play with the empty and the mesh to get equal distance between each array. Then in array modifier, check the merge and the first and last option to connect the end to the starting edge of your mesh. And then just increase the distance value to connect them. Now if you want to move or rotate the mesh, you will need to select empty with the mesh. Otherwise you will have different results. You can also use this to create circular stairways. And this is how I have created this dome. Hope you like it. If you like my tutorial, then subscribe and support me on Patreon, where you will be able to get the project files that I have used in my tutorials. Thanks for watching.